I will give you a high-quality ChatGPT prompt that you instantly can use to generate your Midjourney images. And of course, you will get it for completely free. I know the struggle of writing Midjourney prompts. I feel you. Hence, I've spent months tweaking this, and hopefully it's useful for you. Before handing it over, it makes sense to quickly show you how powerful the ChatGPT prompt is, and I also want to show you how you can use it in the best way for your advantage. Let's take a look. Here it is. My child. Let's paste it into ChatGPT. And to give you an idea of its content, let's quickly skim through it. All prompts must start with /imagine prompt. The Midjourney bot doesn't understand grammar. It has support for all versions. Parameters are supported. It knows tag separation. It knows weighting. I give it a bunch of quality prompt examples. I also feed it keywords for interesting styles, such as chiaroscuro, ferrofluid, and dreamcore. I tell it to be creative and invent own words too. I may instruct you further after this. Please only respond with the prompt and nothing else. Now, let's start very simple, just as a demonstration. And we type kitten in space. We can see that it starts with /imagine prompt, which is not trivial, by the way, because this enables us to instantly copy-paste into Midjourney. Kitten and space environment tells us that it understands the subject. We see an interesting word choice, galaxy core, which seems to be invented because it's not one of the keywords in the instruction. Moreover, it understands weighting, as you can see, version and stylized values. And if we copy-paste the prompt into Midjourney, we can see that we have a kitten in space. How nice. However, a single prompt like this is not the way to take advantage of automation. So, let's look at some more useful applications. And we can start by automating a prompt job of multiple images. And we tell ChatGPT, "Now I want to create Disney-looking mascots originating from different countries. Please use keywords or tags such as CGI, animated film, Disney, cartoon, anime. Please fix prompts for the following countries: USA, Sweden, China, Brazil, and Japan." And if we paste it all over to Midjourney, this is what we get. Maybe we had a YouTube channel and we wanted to make some shorts. Then we could just slam on a flag and add some background music. Quite good for a first iteration. Now, let's step it up further and extract useful information from ChatGPT into our prompt jobs. And for fun, we can make one of those viral Harry Potter bodybuilding videos. And we say, "I'm making a parody short film about Harry Potter and all of its characters being bodybuilders in a gym. Please produce 10 prompts for the most famous characters in the movie series." I might not know the top 10 famous ones, but ChatGPT knows. Apparently, Harry Potter is most famous, and we have Draco Malfoy at 4th place. Moreover, we see the prompt weighting is used quite nicely. We also see some fun keywords like Weasley's Whey Protein Corner. Even tags like Lightning Bolt Tattoo for Harry Potter or Ginger Beard for Ron Weasley shows that ChatGPT is fetching some valuable information. Anyway, let's paste it all into Midjourney. By the way, this copy-pasting can quite easily be automated by an external script or even a Discord bot. But unfortunately, it's against Midjourney's TOS. Damn it. Looking at the images, we see it didn't quite work. Some aesthetics are right, but the faces are horrendous. Because by name, Midjourney does not quite know how to depict the Harry Potter characters. But there's an easy fix. We just tell ChatGPT to add the actual name of the actor or actress. It's important to leave this work to ChatGPT because we don't want to use our own brains. So we say, let's make some adjustments. Firstly, let's add the name of the actor. Secondly, let's add the photorealism tag. And lastly, let's make sure they're all depicted as bodybuilders. To guide you, here's an example prompt. From experience, I strongly recommend to do this, to add an example prompt, because it ensures that you get exactly what you want. So we add Daniel Radcliffe and photorealism flexing. And we say, please follow this formula for all other characters. And reading the names, we see Daniel Radcliffe, Emma Watson, Rupert Grint, Tom Felton. Success. Nice. To see if it improved, let's head over to Midjourney. Now we see it's clearly better. It's not perfect, but the bottom left one is quite good. And Ron is still a mess, okay. Here the bottom right one I think is quite okay. And this was a nice one. Keep in mind that these are all the first seeds, because I want to stay truthful to you guys. So if we wanted to quickly turn this into a video, we could just save all the images that we liked. We add some simple dialogue in 11 labs. We smash that break button in DID. Maybe we extract some depth maps from the Midas hugging phase. And we animate a displaced node in DaVinci Resolve. Then we can get something like this.
Our biggest difference is, Potter, I don't skip leg day.
Now, of course, we could improve the quality by upscaling the images in automatic 1111 or generating further seeds. But thanks to ChatGPT, this process got a lot quicker. Now, right before giving you the ChatGPT prompt, I want to give you some small trivia. I've informed it what styles the Midjourney versions excel at. So if you tell it to produce anime images, it tends to know that you want to use the Niji 5 version, and it can also use different styles such as expressive, original, or scenic. Also, since the prompt contains many high-quality words and instructions to be inventive, so if you don't know what to generate, you can also use it for inspiration or creativity. For example, you can say, please produce 3 hyper-realistic crazy prompts of macro footage. And we see it comes up with some interesting ideas like dewdrop on a spider web, morning sun glare, prismatic reflections. Also, see that it uses the style raw and a quite high stylized value. Note that sometimes ChatGPT can start hallucinating and give you strange results like version 5.8. If that happens, just guide it with an example prompt or start a new chat. The prompt also works with GPT 3.5, but be aware of the low token input limit of that model. I recommend using it with GPT 4 if you have it. And finally, you can find the full prompt in the pinned comment below. And if you want updates, you can also find it on my GitHub page in the description. Thanks for watching and good luck prompting!